Hello there. Now we're going to take a look at patterns. If you had a chance to watch the block editing video before this, you'll have a good foundation for what patterns are and kind of how to handle them. If you haven't done that yet, I recommend going back to it or checking it out. So patterns are essentially a collection of blocks that make up bigger parts of content. So patterns are things like your header. Like right here, we have this bird icon, the title, and then my navigation. Those are grouped together in a parent block. So if I open this list view, you're going to see that I have a header block and I have this drop down arrow that'll show me everything that's in there. And a lot of times you actually have multiple parent blocks to control different sections or house different blocks. So that group block houses another set of blocks. This group block specifically has just this headline, but the header block itself includes rows that include the site title and the image and the actual navigation. Using these layout blocks in different ways gives you more control and helps kind of with overall stability of the design. And everybody tends to use them a little bit differently. But patterns are basically blocks that are housed within those parent or layout blocks. Query loop is the same thing. Footer is the same thing. Now, it can be overwhelming to try and build something like this block by block by block. And one of the coolest things about patterns is you can get something that's already been built by a professional and designed by professionals and just drop it into your site and adapt it to kind of your design. And in fact, they adapt for you in a lot of cases. So let's look at adding just a simple newsletter pattern. The first thing I'm going to do is go up to the inserter and click on that plus sign. Now notice you have patterns, blocks, or media. We're going to stick with patterns. And I'm going to scroll down to newsletter. Now it's going to load the patterns that are available. And some of these come from the WordPress.com pattern library. Some of them may come from the .org featured section, and some of them may just be part of your theme. The really cool thing about this, like I mentioned, is that they actually use, like this example uses color palette from my theme, it uses my image, it would use my title and tagline and show you exactly what it looks like when you drop it in. So if you have that stuff filled out, you'll drop it in and it'll be literally ready to go. I'm going to scroll down. I'm going to choose this pattern with all the different birds on it. So you'll notice I got a notification that said it was inserted on the page. I can see it right here. If I couldn't see it, I would just use the list view to find the new block that got dropped in. So it is this cover block. I'm going to close the list view so we can look at it. Now, it at least has my bird on it, but it doesn't look like it belongs on the page right now. And it's kind of hard to read. So first thing I'm going to do is look at the parent block itself and decide if I want to maybe make it a different color. Now, I don't have colors in this primary settings block, but I'm going to go to show more settings like we looked at before. And I'm going to choose to explore my color options. Now I can go with this blue, and that is the same blue as the text, and that kind of looks nice. And then it's broken up by this bird again, and then it goes back to more blue for this query loop. I can also just go with this cream color and make it feel like it's all one thing. But then these birds kind of look weird to me. So I'm going to go back to that blue. I thought that looked nice. And I'm going to close my settings to see. Now, the biggest thing that stands out is I can't really read that subscribe. So if I go back to that cover block and I open it, you'll see all the columns, multiple columns in there that are holding the birds. But what if I just click on that subscribe block? It's going to show you exactly where it is, which column it's in within there, and it's going to take me to the settings for that subscribe block. Now, all I really need to do is change that button color or the button text. So I can change the button text like this dark blue, which makes it pretty easy to read. And then I have that cream color for contrast. So overall, we didn't have to change much. We changed the background of the cover block. We changed the text for the subscribe button, and that was it. That's where patterns save you a lot of time. So I recommend exploring different patterns for different pieces, especially when you're building content from scratch. And if you ever can't find a pattern that you're looking for, I do recommend checking out wordpress.org/patterns because they have a really cool piece of functionality where you can literally copy it from here and paste it into your site. So if I put a paragraph block in here, I can just paste it and it's going to pull that whole thing in there, which is pretty cool. So tons of patterns all over the place that you can leverage, tons of options, and tons of time to be saved.